Folks, with me at this time is none other than Paul Roma, a WWE star from the 80s and the 90s. Thank you so much for joining us here.
Oh, it's nice to be here, man.
Go ahead. I wanted to ask you about your school, Paradise Wrestling.
Paradise Alley. Yeah, Paradise Alley. Well, we're in East Haven, Connecticut. We just joined forces with Evolve. We have avenues to GLOW. We have avenues to Lucha Underground. We got a great core of people. It's it's a really close-knit family, all the guys. So we teach old school. Some of the guys, they'll do some lucha if they need to. But for the most part, it's old school and probably the only school that I know of that teaches ring psychology.
And that was my next question. The basis of your school, what do you look for in the student? You look for more of the in-ring, the psychology, not so much high-flying spots, is that it?
If somebody's already seasoned, then I kind of see where his thought pattern's at. What's he thinking? Is he just taking bumps to take bumps, or is he, do they make sense? So, and when someone's starting out, then I just like to put them in the ring in the beginning, see what they have, see how they, how comfortable they are in the ring. And then we go from there.
I wanted to ask you about your memories of Hercules. You tag teaming him for a long time. What are your memories of Hercules?
Absolute love. If anybody had love for a man, I have love for him. He's the greatest guy that I ever met, other than my dad, the greatest guy I've ever met. Paul Orndorff, another phenomenal guy. SD Jones, Arn was a good guy, but nobody was like Ray.
You guys were supposed to have the belts. I mean, you guys were really hot. You put Shawn Michaels out of action with the whole Rockers deal. I mean, what happened there?
We won the belts at Nassau Coliseum against the Hart Foundation, and they said we cheated, so they took them away. Ray told me we'll never see him again, and he was right that we'd never see him again. For whatever reason, maybe it's because Ray and I created Power and Glory, and it wasn't Vince. Maybe that was the reason why. His ego couldn't handle that. Somebody else figured something out.
Did you guys come up with the look, the shades, the everything? Is that what it?
We came up with the cutoffs. He had Power, I had Glory on my shirt. We came up with no matter what happens, I'm always going to go in and get the three count. That's the Glory, right?
Even that finish when Hercules would, give him for the super.
Duplicated, yeah. Man. Greatest finish ever, and we never practiced it. People don't believe that, but it's a gospel truth. We were driving up to Minnesota, and he said, "Hey, we don't have a finish." And I said, "Well, give me a few minutes. Let me think of something." And I said, "What do you think of this?" And he says, "You think we could pull it off?" I said, "Oh, hell yeah! You and me, man, we could do anything." So we did. The glasses—they weren't really what we wanted, but that's what the office came up with. So we wore them out to the ring.
You actually almost had a career-ending injury. I mean, you had—is that your elbow was like almost detached at WrestleMania 7, and you had to wrestle? I mean, that was really.
Yeah, I went to the hospital that day. They advised that I shouldn't wrestle. I spoke to Vince about it. He begged me. He said he needed us out there. Ray retore his groin, so he had trouble getting out to the ring. So they said, just give me a minute. If you guys should just go in the ring for 1 minute, we'll be happy. So Ray and I went in the ring for 1 minute.
And, close us out. What do you think, you're an athlete, so I wanted to ask you an off-topic wrestling question. The NFL players, they're on strike and they're kneeling for the national anthem. What are your thoughts on that?
I love all our service people. First and foremost, I love the American flag, what it stands for, what everybody's fought so hard for. As far as the NFL players, it's not the platform to be doing something and disrespecting the flag. The reason that you have that option of kneeling down is because of those service people that fought for you. All the wars. It wasn't just the war that we're in now or last year. It's from the beginning of time. And I think it's disgraceful. I don't go to games. I was given tickets to a game, but I was afraid that I was going to run down, start screaming at you pieces of shit, and hope that you would call me down on the field. I'd throw down with any of you. And I'm just going to say, again, God bless our service people. And I wish more of the servicemen would walk over to those players and stand in front of them and, you know, give them a little insult back, so to speak. That's what I think. Is that enough?
That is enough.
Because I'm starting to get a little riled up and angry about this. You know what I mean? That's a sore subject. Again, we play the national anthem at every Paradise Alley show. We actually have one of our partners, his daughter comes out and sings it. And everybody stands.
It really is a close-knit family.
It's a close-knit family. So, yeah.
Final word. Any regrets at all in your illustrious career?
No regrets. No, I did what I had to do. I did it for a reason. Ray and I came together for a reason, which was to reach out to kids, you know, kids that were not healthy. And we did that. And that was the agreement that we had. And we both kept our word. Should have gone on longer. Yeah, it would have been nice to reach out to more kids. But you know what? It worked.
Thank you so much, Paul. I really appreciate your time.
Thanks for having me.